here's how you judge weight. You judge weight based on your goal. Okay? Our goal in this particular exercise is to maintain muscle and maybe even build a little strength, right? Okay? Well, in order to do that, you need to work at a percentage of your maximum ability that's going to allow for that type of result. So if you can barely do one on something, you're working at 100% of your ability. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay. So if we're working at 100% at one, we know that each repetition is going to be a smaller percentage than 100. At about 10 to 15 repetitions, in that range, that's about 65 to about 85%. And that's the range that we need to work at to get the goal that you're looking for. So most people that come in to work out, they do 10 or 15 repetitions of something, they just stop. If they don't work toward failure, they don't really know what percentage they're working with. So your goal is to work to failure so that you know what percentage you're working at, so that you know that you're getting what you want out of the exercise. So you need to be pushing yourself to 20, not just doing 10 or 15 and stopping. Because if you're not, then what's the point? If you work at 50%, you're never going to get any stronger.
Well, I want my chest to look like yours, so I'm going for it.
I don't need more than two sets of anything right now. Because right now it's still a learning process, which is why we're doing a higher repetition range. Instead of 10 to 15 repetitions, we're doing that 20 repetitions. What we're really trying to do is develop some focus first, get that neuromuscular connection down. And then once you have that, then you can start increasing the intensity. Once your body starts getting used to the resistance training and learns how to repair, because again, like you said, you probably are. You're going to be sore just because not move with that much resistance
right.
In that manner.
So I should do that set, and then go on to this other exercise, and come back and do one more.
Exactly. We'll do